evening, everyone. Carol here at Oak House Journals, and it's time for me to start another Sashiko-inspired embroidery piece. Now, I have to say that this one comes with a bit of a government health warning because it is a study in French knots. And I know that French knots are a bit like Marmite. Some people love them, some people hate them. And if you know me, I love them. So I've got my bits and bobs here ready. I've got some white DMC thread here, lots of shades of white actually. I've got my navy blue fabric and I've got my little wee embroidery hoop tucked away in here. So, when I can get it out, there we go, in here. So, why is it a study in French knots? Well, I saw the image that I want to work on Pinterest last year and decided that I would like to give it a try. But recently I've been doing another little project, which is 101 and more French knots. I've been working this little cherry blossom tree. Now, this is for another fabric journal, sewing journal that I'm working on behind the scenes. I will do a show and tell at the end of the year or towards the end of the year when it's done. But this is one of the pieces I was doing recently. And as you can see, millions and millions of French knots. And this Sashiko inspired embroidery piece is no different from that. So this is the image. As I say, it's one I saw on Pinterest, so not my own idea at all. But it's one that I've wanted to try for a wee while now. And the reason I like it is because I imagine doing all of these with French knots. Now I'm going to flip it around in terms of the colourway. I'm going to be working white French knots on my navy blue fabric. And I will be putting a little pop of colour, as I always do for these. So I will be working a couple or maybe just one French knot in red somewhere on here. Now, the reason I wanted to have a go at doing this is because I like the idea that up here, all the French knots are really random. And then down here, they're more linear. So I thought that that would be something fun to try. And also, you know me, I adore my French knots. So the first thing I'm going to do is mark out a rectangle on my fabric and then hoop it up. I'm definitely going to be working in a hoop because for me that makes it a lot easier to do the wraps of the French knot. What also makes it easier is if you've got a frame or something that will support your hoop, or as I do, work on either a New Zealand mat, wool mat, or the arm of the sofa, if I'm honest. When I'm watching television, I'll use the arm of a sofa to anchor my needle into as I'm doing the wraps of my thread around my needle. I just find it so much easier. And of course, if you're playing along, which I know some of you are, if you're not into French knots, you don't have to do French knots. There's loads of other little knots, colonial knots, for example, that you can do instead of the French knots. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. Now, you'll see me do a couple of French knots to start off with, and then I'll do some pictures along the way because it'll be like watching paint dry. Watching me do a million and one French knots. So as always, I'll do some pictures along the way and then I'll come back to you when I've done the finished piece. So see you in a while. just thought I'd stop along the way and show you how this is progressing. And as you can see, I've done probably about a million and one French knots on here, but it's been quite relaxing doing it in the evenings, just something that I could pick up, watch the television, watch a film or listen to an audiobook and just stitch away. I'm liking how the texture has built up, especially along this top edge here. And I've just filled in French knot upon French knot to make it really dense. And it is slightly textured. And I've also done the same down here. Now, I'll tell you why I've done those. I've actually made quite a bad rookie mistake on this piece. When I cut out my piece of fabric to go in the hoop, I didn't leave enough at the sides here and at the bottom to be able to maintain good tension on my fabric that's in the hoop. Now, it doesn't sound too bad at the moment, but trust me, it actually works itself loose as I'm stitching. So I am constantly pulling at the side here. I can't tighten up my hoop anymore. It won't allow me to do that. So yes, a rookie mistake, and the outcome of that means that I haven't been able to maintain a uniform tension on my fabric in the hoop. Therefore, my sewing area has become distorted, as you can see by this line down here, and also at the bottom here. It's not the ends of the earth with this particular piece, for the simple reason that it's created by all these French knots. So if I find when I take it out of the hoop and give it a press and take away the guidelines that I don't have a uniform rectangle there, then I can just fill in the gaps using the French knots. But if I was doing a traditional embroidery, then obviously I would have caused myself a whole heap of problems. The knock-on effect though has been that up here was supposed to be random French knots and down here they were supposed to be more linear. They do probably look linear, but they're not straight lines. And that was because my fabric was was wonky in the frame. So effectively, it's given me more random, a more random look down here than I actually wanted. But I was loving this texture up here so much that it's actually been a happy accident, because I've started to do texture down here as well, just again by building up the French knots one on top of each other. So as you can see, I've done a couple of lines here and I've also taken my thread to one side here, and I'm going to do another line going probably about three quarters of the way across there, and then I'm probably going to work another one in. I know you should go with uneven numbers, but I might actually put another one here, or even maybe another two, I don't know. But I just thought I'd stop along the way and show you that, because obviously I hadn't mentioned that I was going to be doing this, and let you have a closer look at what the whole thing looks like. So, still got a little way to go, but almost there now, so I will go off. Here we go, everybody. This is the final piece. I've done my last French knot on this, and I'm really pleased with the textures that I got. So, let's take it out of the ring and see how distorted the rectangle has got. Not too bad, I don't think, for that rookie mistake. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and give this a good press and see exactly what additional stitches I need to do to make the shape more regular. It looks like I need to do a little bit more down here, perhaps a little bit up there. We'll see. Anyway, I'll be back after it's pressed so that you can have a look, and we'll take it from there. So I've given it a little press and it's not too bad actually. I was right, I am going to need to do a few more French knots down the side here just to make the shape more regular. So I obviously spoke too soon when I said I'd finish my last French knot on this. So I'm just going to get those French knots done and take this guideline thread away, trim it to size, and I will show you some pictures at the end. So as always, everybody, thank you so much for bearing with me, letting me share my work with you. I really do appreciate it. And obviously, please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more of what I do. Take care, everybody. Have a great week. Bye.